Okay guys, let's continue our lessons. Today I want to teach you how to sketch rational function in form y equals to ax squared plus bx plus c over px squared plus qx plus r. Yeah, or maybe y equals to bx plus c over px squared, or maybe y equals to c over px squared. Yeah, so the denominator always have x squared, but for numerator it can be x squared or not. Okay. The steps, how to sketch. First, find y-intercept. It means x equals to 0, you have to substitute x equals to 0 to the function. And then find x-intercept, it means y equals to 0. First, you have to cross multiply and then factorize, or maybe you, if you cannot factorize, you can use quadratic formula to find the values of x, and then you will get x-intercept. Number 3, find the values of y for each range of x. How? Look at the example questions below. I will explain these steps for you after we go to the example questions. Next, number 4, find the horizontal asymptotes y equals to a over c. Oh no no no, not y over c. A over p. Sorry guys. A over p. Okay, this one is a over p. And then if we don't have a, yeah, for these types, b plus c, and then c only, it means we don't have a, right? So the horizontal asymptotes will be y equals to 0. And then number 5, find the vertical asymptotes. Make the denominator equals to 0, or px squared plus qx plus r equals to 0. And then you have to find the roots, that is the vertical asymptotes. And then number 6, find the extreme, vertex, maximum, minimum point using this formula. Yeah, 2ax plus b, and then times this, and then minus this, and then that. Okay, I will explain this to you after we go to the example questions. And then you have to using your calculator, yeah. And then number 7, find the point of intersection between the function and the horizontal asymptotes, if any. Substitute the horizontal asymptotes into the function, and then find another point if needed, and then 9, sketch. Okay, that is the steps. I know it's so many, yeah, so you have to pay attention for each step in the example questions. Okay, so the example questions is this one. Example 1, sketch y equals to x squared minus x minus 6 over x squared plus 2x minus 3. You have to differ each form, yeah. Last time we already learned about this one, ax plus b over cx plus d, yeah. It's different from this one. Now we have x squared, yeah. If you have x squared in rational function, you have to use these steps, okay. The first step is find y-intercept x equals to 0. So this is the first step. Number 1. So x equals to 0, we have to substitute x equals to 0. So y equals to, in the bracket, 0 square minus 0 minus 6. Yeah, I will write later. Plus 2 times x, 0 minus 3. So we change the x into 0, 0, 0, 0. The result will be negative 6 over negative 3 equals to 2. From this one, we already got the y-intercept, which is 0,2. Okay, this is the first step. And then the second step. The second step, we have to find x-intercept, which means y equals to 0. So we have to substitute y into 0. 0 equals to x squared minus x minus 6 over x squared plus 2x minus 3, yeah. And then you have to cross multiply, guys. Cross multiply, that means this times this equals to 0 equals to x squared minus x minus 6. And then you have to factorize, or maybe quadratic formula. If you don't remember what is quadratic formula, it's x1,2 equals to negative b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a, yeah. This is for finding roots of quadratics. 0 equals to, I think we can factorize this one, x 3 2 minus and plus. So I will have x equals to 3, x equals to negative 2. Therefore the x-intercept will be 3,0 and negative 2,0. Next, the third step, Okay, the next is we have to find the values of y for each range of x, whether it is positive or negative. Only the sign, yeah, not the value. Sorry. Find the sign of y for each range of x. Okay. So for these steps, yeah, I want to explain it to you using these examples. Okay. So first, you have to find the roots of numerator and denominator. Roots of numerator first. Numerator. Denominator is x squared minus x minus 6. You have to make it into 0. So you will have x minus 3, x plus 2. You already calculate this one on the second step, yeah. So you can copy it. Okay, so we have 3 and negative 2. And then I have to find the roots of denominator also. Denominator, yeah, so it will be x squared plus 2x minus 3 equals to 0, and then you have to factorize it, x plus 3, x minus 1 equals to 0, yeah, so x will be negative 3 and x equals to 1. Okay, to get the values, the sign of y, you have to use a line number. Number line, yeah, and then you have to draw like this, and then you will have negative 3, and then you have negative 2, and then 1, and then 3, and then you have to test for x equals to 0. Okay, put the 0 into the function, so it will be 0 square minus 0 minus 6 over 0 plus 0 minus 3 equals to positive 2. We only need the positive, yeah, the positive. So x equals to 0 is positive. You have to locate x equals to 0. It will be right here. And then on the top of it, you draw the plus sign. And then each time it jumps the numbers, it changes the sign, negative. And then jump again, positive. Jump to the left side, negative. Jump to the left side again, positive. Okay, so the sign will be positive, negative, positive, negative, and positive. This is means when the range of x is between negative 2 and 1, the curve will be above the x-axis. Yeah, this is means above x-axis. Yeah, if it is positive. And if it is negative, that means the curve later will be below the x-axis, yeah. Okay, below, above, below, above, and so on. This one is above. Okay, so number four. Okay, number four, find the horizontal asymptotes. The formula is y equals to a over p, yeah. Later in 11th grade, you will learn how to make this formula. Okay, this formula is from the chapters in 11th grade. Okay, so in the meantime, you only have to use this formula. So y will be a over p. A is this one in front of x squared in the numerator. Yeah, it's one. And then p, what is p? P is this one. Yeah, the number in front of x square on the denominator, yeah, so 1 and 1, okay, this is 1 and this is 1, 1 over 1, so y will be 1, this is the horizontal asymptotes. Next, okay, next is the vertical asymptotes. You have to make the denominator equals to 0, yeah, so the vertical asymptotes will be denominator, the denominator is this one, you have to make it into 0, and then you have to find the roots, yeah. Find the root means factorize or quadratic formula. X plus 3, x minus 1 equals to 0, so x will be negative 3 and x equals to 1. So this is the vertical asymptote 1 and 2, yeah. There are two vertical asymptotes. Next, okay, next is we have to find the extreme points or vertex point or maximum point or minimum point using this formula. Okay, this formula is get from the chapters in grade 11 also. So because you are not learn about the chapters, I will tell you the easiest way to calculate this one. Okay, so first we have to follow the rules. Yeah, the rules is in the bracket 2ax 2 times a, this is a, right? A is 1 times x, and then plus b, this is b, b is negative 1. Okay, and then px squared is the same with the denominator, so you only have to copy the all of the denominator. Yeah, x squared plus 2x minus 3, and then you have to minus it with ax squared plus bx plus c. This one is the same with the numerator, you have to only copy the numerator and then times it again with 2px plus q. Yeah, 2px mean 2 times p, p is this one, this p, 1 x, and then plus q, q is this one, okay, plus 2. Get it? And then make it 0. Later you have to find the roots using a calculator. Yeah, so this one will be 2x minus 1, and then times it with x squared plus 2x minus 3, and then for this one x squared minus x minus 6, 2x plus 2 equals to 0. You have to cross multiply. Yeah, and then 2x cubed plus 4x squared, and then negative 6x, this one negative x squared, this one negative 2x, and this one plus 3, minus in the brackets, still in the brackets, this one 2x cubed, and then plus 2x squared, this one negative, sorry, no, not like that, oh yeah, yeah, correct, negative 2x squared, and then this one negative 2x, and then this one negative 12x, and then the last one negative 12, okay, equals to 0. Next, we have to simplify, yeah. So it will be 2x squared plus 4x plus 3x squared, and then minus 8x, and then plus 3, minus 2x cubed. This one is gone. So we only have to negative 14x, positive 14x, and then plus 12 equals to 0. Okay, so wait a minute, this is 3, this one will be gone, and then we only have 3x squared plus 6x plus 36 equals to 0. Oh, this one does not need a calculator to calculate, yeah. Plus 2x, you can divide by 2, plus 12 equals to 0. Okay, so after this you have to find the roots, yeah, but this one cannot be factorized. If you use a general formula, it will be like this, x1, 2 equals to negative b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac over 2a, yeah. So x1, 2 equals to negative b, negative 2 plus minus square root of b square, 4 minus 4 times a, 1 times c is 12, over 2 times 1. So the roots will be negative 2 plus minus square root of 48, negative 44, yeah, over 2. Okay, this one cannot be calculated because the square root is negative. Yeah, we cannot find the result of negative inside the square root. Okay, so we can tell that this graph doesn't have turning point. Okay, later maybe in the next example I can find the turning points. Okay, so for this one doesn't have. Next, and then next is you have to find the point of intersection between the function and the horizontal asymptotes, yeah. So in step 2 or step 3, we already have the horizontal asymptotes, which is x equals to 1. You only have to substitute the 1 into the x at the y, sorry. So 1 will be x squared minus x minus 6 over x squared plus 2x minus 3. We can cross multiply it, so x squared plus 2x minus 3 equals to x squared minus x minus 6, and then the x squared will be gone. You will use your algebra to solve this. So it will be 3x equals to negative 6 plus 3, negative 3, x equals to negative 1. From this one, we will have the point of intersection between the curve and the horizontal asymptotes, yeah, which is negative 1, 1. After this, if you want, you can try to find another points, but maybe we can draw it directly. Let's try to draw it. Okay, so far we already get this information: y-intercept, x-intercept, the sine of the sine of y, and then horizontal asymptotes, y equals to 1, vertical asymptotes, and then no turning point. Intersection between curve and the horizontal asymptotes will be negative 1, 1. So first we have to draw the asymptotes. Yeah, the asymptotes is a line, dot line. Yeah, for horizontal asymptotes y equals to 1, you only find y equals to 1 right here, and then you draw horizontal lines, dot horizontal lines. Yeah, like that. Okay, this is the horizontal asymptotes. Next is the vertical asymptotes. Vertical asymptotes will be x equals to negative 3. Find x equals to negative 3. It's right here. And then draw vertical lines. X equals to 1 also. Draw vertical lines. And then put all of the points. The first point is 0,2. It's right here. And then negative 3,0. It's right here. Negative 2,0 is right here. And then negative 1,1 also right here. And then we have above, below, above, below, above. That means later the curve will be above the, for this one, yeah, for x less than negative 3, it will be above. Above means the graph will be above the x-axis. And then for negative 3 and negative 2, it will be below, right here. And then above again, negative 3 until 1, it will be right here. And then below, 1 until 3 below, and then right there. Okay, so our curve will be on the circle position. Yeah, wait, we cannot draw like this because the points is very few, yeah, we cannot draw. Okay, so we need another points. For example, I want to calculate x equals to negative 4, and then I need x equals to 2 maybe. Yeah, so this one y will be wait a minute. Okay, so you have to put x equals to 2 into the function. It will be 2 square minus 2 minus 6 over 2 square plus 2x minus 3, yeah. The result will be 4 minus 2 is 2, 2 minus 6 negative 4, and then for this one 2 4 4 8 5. Okay, negative 4 over 5, negative 0.8. So this one will be negative 0.8. And then the second one, negative 4, will be 2.8. Okay, so we have another points, 2, negative 0.8, 2, negative 0.8, and then negative 4, 2.8, negative 4, 2.8, it's right there. Okay, so we can connect the dots, yeah. First is this one. Remember, the asymptote is a line that is very close to the curve, yeah. So for this one, we have to draw it like this. Okay, draw it like this. Yeah, the curve will be very close to the asymptote. Very close to the asymptote. Okay, and then for the second one, I cannot draw it like this, okay? Because the curve needs to be very close with the asymptote. Yeah, it will be like this maybe. Okay, and then like that. And then the third one, it will be right here, yeah. Because it says below, this one is below, and this one will be above. There you go. That is the graph. Oh my god, it takes 30 minutes to draw one graph, yeah. Okay, next. Okay guys, I think I should end this lesson now, yeah, so you can practice lot of sketching. So I will guide you after this, join my meetings, okay? I will guide you how to draw the exercise. Okay, thank you guys, see you.